Now, before we dive deeper into the more sophisticated algorithms, I would like to briefly tell you a little bit about a technique known as brute force. So what does brute force mean? Does it mean that we take a hammer and beat the answer out of our computer? Of course not. Brute force is the algorithm that Alice, Bob, and Carol were using initially. So you'll remember, for example, that for Bob, we were using an algorithm like this, or not using, but proposing an algorithm like this, at least, that simply went through all possible assignments of 0 and 1 to the vertices, or at that time we still call them genes. And the weakness of this algorithm was that it had a pretty unacceptable running time as soon as you got to more than 20 or 30 vertices in the network. But this algorithm actually also has two strengths. One strength of it is that it's very simple. And the other thing is that because it's so simple, you can actually also implement it rather fast. So under certain conditions, using an algorithm like this actually might not be that bad an idea. And this method of using all possible assignments, so first of all, we're not going to use the hammer here, this method of going through all possible assignments without any more sophisticated techniques or sophisticated algorithmic techniques is known as brute force. And so, as I've just explained to you, there are certain conditions where brute force is actually desirable. So let's have you figure out what those conditions could be. And by brute force, we of course mean try all possibilities. Could it be that when you don't have much time to design and program a more sophisticated algorithm? Could it be when the instances or the inputs for which you're trying to solve your problem are small? So say n, the size of the problem is smaller than 20? Or could it be when you need to solve the problem only once and the input might be a little bit bigger there? So for each one, I'm going to give you two choices, whether under these conditions using brute force could be okay. And the first one is a maybe, and the second one is a definitive no. I'm not going to give you a clear yes choice, because obviously since we're dealing with NP-complete problems here, brute force is never generally advisable, of course.